Welcome back to School of Civil Engineering. This is Hedadullah with another new interesting video. As we have started full building detailing tutorials, how we'll create a building detailings to provide our client, and this is very, very important for engineer, actually for a structural engineer and also for a estimator to learn about that, how to make a detailing for a building. So we have started that, and in our previous two lecture I have just shown you that about my real project detailing here, and also I have just shown you that here that is my detailed project detailing. In another video I have just shown you that how we'll create the template. That every time that's not possible to create every time a new template, so I'll just create a template, and after completing our work I'll just give the data here. So I'll just scaling and I'll give that data here. That's it. So in our previous video I have shown you that, so even if you new here you can watch our previous video, and I think you will learn something better. And also if you need to know about many types of software tutorials, then that are also available in this channel. I have already complete almost civil engineering related 20 plus software tutorials, and I think that will be very, very helpful for you. I have just focus on the software that are really, really important for civil engineers, so I have just focus on that software, and I have created more video on that software. So let's start, and before starting I'm just requesting you, if you're a civil engineer and if you're here, that means you're a civil engineer, so please subscribe our channel and press the bell icon, because your support is very, very required for us. So I'll just open our that previous template from here. Just see here, that is our previous template. That is our previous template here. Now the question is, our template is ready actually here. Our template is ready. Now I have told you that in this lecture I'll just show you that how we'll create a column detailing. How will create a column detailing? So I'll just create a detailing and I will give that data here. So let's start. So for that I will use my I'll just use that layout and I'll just show you about it. So for that layout, before that I'll go in foundation and I'll just select a foundation here. I'm selecting a foundation, it's 7 feet 10 inch, so I'll just consider that our foundation is 8 feet by 8 feet, for our work purpose. 8 feet by 8 feet, and here it's 1 feet 1.8 inch. I'll just consider that our depth is 12 inch. So, and our column size, I'll just consider that our column size is 12 inch into 12 inch. So first of all here we have to just forget about that. Forget about that plan, forget about that plan. Just I will work here first time. So first time zoom it, and from here by using that point, first of all draw a foundation, cross section of a foundation, an elevation. So first of all, what will be our foundation from that point to, and obviously on your offset, ortho, then here our foundation will be, our foundation will be 8 feet, 8 feet, then enter. So zoom out, so here 8 feet, then go up, and the height was, or the height was 12 inch, done. Then again take your mouse here and here, so it's done. Now I will take a point here, and before taking point I'll just Before taking point, I will take clear cover for our first layer. So what will be the clear cover? It will be 3. We know that as it is contact as soil directly, I mean contact with earth, then I will take its 3. So click offset, then 3 inch. Okay, enter and take offset of it. Okay, it's done. So here is our one layer of our, this is the one layer of our reinforcement. Okay, now I'll just take a line. So from here I'll take the middle point, or here I'll just take middle point, and from that point to I'll go in top. So as our building, I'm just considering our building is two-story building, so our total height, okay, total height of our building will be first 6 feet, then 11 feet, then 11 feet. Okay, so now the total will be 28. Okay, 28 from that point. Okay, 28 from that point. So I'm just skipping, and here I'll just again I'll take a line. So from that point I'll take a line. So I'll just give it 28 feet, then enter. So it's done. It's done. Actually, it's depend on you that how you will draw your structure. I mean, how will detailing that? It's totally depend on you. I am just showing you my way that how I detailing, how I use detailing. Okay. So here, then I'll take offset as our column was 12 inch. Okay. Then I'll take O. Then offset I'll take 16 inch in both side. Then offset here 6 and here 6. So just see here, it's done. Now I will take trim tier, then I'll just delete that and delete that. Just see here, it's done. And now I'll take, also I'll take offset here. Okay, again go offset, then what will be the offset, the offset will be 3 inch. So for that just simply select that, and for that side also take a 3 inch offset. So again it's done. Now again use trim tier, double enter, then offset that point, and also take offset here. Okay, it is done. In this detailing I'll just consider that our inner foundation, they have one layer reinforcement. Okay, so from here, from that top point we'll also take a 3 inch clear cover. So again escape, then O, then enter, then again enter, 3 inch are all already taken. So from here again take 3 inch, so escape, then TR, double enter, then close that and close that, and escape, then delete that. Now see that our the bottom reinforcement are okay. Now we'll take a fillet here, we'll use fillet here. Okay, so for that use F, then enter, then we have to select the radius. So what will be the radius? I'll just consider our that radius will be 4 inch. Okay, that will be suppose 4 inch, then 4, then enter. Now select the first object and select the second object. Just see here, it is actually this is too much, this is too much. I'll go Ctrl Z, and then I will escape, then again click fillet F, click here, and from here radius, and I'll just take 1 inch, then enter. So that point, just see here, it's done. Again enter. Okay, then click here 1, it's okay, and then first point, that point, it's done. Just see here, our the bending are also ready. Now we'll go for our next part. Okay, so here I'll just give reinforcement here. So I'll take circle, and I'll just draw a circle anywhere. So what will be the circle diameter? I'll just consider that a circle diameter of radius 0.5. okay, enter. So here is our circle radius. Okay, so I'll just take it. Okay, and from here let's CO, copy, control escape, sorry, select that and click CO, then enter, and it's telling us specify base point. So I'll just specify that point as a base point, and I will hoist off our ortho mode, and here I'll just simply give her the reinforcement. Okay, so from here also I'll just give a reinforcement here, and also I'll give reinforcement. Actually it depends on you according to your plan. Okay, how much reinforcement you'll give. I'm just giving a random value here, here one, then here one, then here one. Consider that, and here on. So it's done, right? It's done. Now in that side I'll give reinforcement here on. Actually I'm just giving a random data, and here on it's done. Just you have to calculate that how much bar you are providing here. Okay, how much bar you are providing here, and with respect that data you have to make that detailing. So I'll just escape that, then delete. So our the bottom reinforcement is okay. Okay, our bottom reinforcement is okay. Now here for our that bar I will just take offset for that side and that side. Okay, for first time I will take offset for 3 inches. Okay, I'll take offset for 3 inches. Now they have a problem actually. So first of all I will draw our upper side of our column. So for that I'll again take offset, and what will be the height? It's 6 feet, 6 feet from our grade beam to our foundation level depth, 6 feet. Then take offset here, just see here, there we have drawn 6 feet. Now here we have to give her, foundation depth, our grade beam depth. So I'll just again take offset, enter offset, and I'll consider that our foundation is 16, I mean our that depth is 16 inches. Okay, then I'll give 16, then from here I'll just take, here it's done, escape, then it's done. Then again I'll take from that point to that level to upper level, it's 11. I'll just take it again, enter for offset, then here 11 feet, enter. So from that point to that point it's 11 feet. Again enter, here it's 11 feet. Just see here, you have to draw that, and again I'll take create offset, and I'll consider that our the depth of our upper beam is 15 inches. Just consider that 15.5 inches. Enter here, here. Okay, just consider that this is our corner foundation. Just consider this is a corner foundation, and if you also want that, you can give that data, that beam level in that set. Okay, now I'll close that, and I'll just give here offset. Now the our first problem is from that point to that point, from that point to that point, our foundation section, I mean that foundation section, that will be, I mean sorry, or that column section, that will be more than that section column. I mean that column cross section, okay, area of column cross section, because here this column will remain under soil, that's why its dimension will be more than that, right? So before that, I'll just draw our detailing soil. Randomly I will take 1.5 inch clear cover. So again I'll click offset or enter, then 1.5, then enter. I'll take this for reinforcement and this is for our longitudinal reinforcement. So just see here, it's done, right? Now actually from here, consider that from here, I'll just considering that point, I'll just open ortho, just take your mouse here to make that point, okay, I mean to adjust that point here, it's done, then click here and adjust it here. So it's done. Again, take it, otherwise you can take a mirror here. Actually you can take a mirror, and actually I think that will be good. So just select that and select that and click MI, enter, then specify the first point of mirror line. So consider that this is our first point and this is our last point. It's done, then enter. So it's done, then escape. So we have successfully draw our that reinforcement, okay, our column longitudinal reinforcement. Now I'll just go here, I'll just trim it, tear, enter, double enter, then click here. So it's done, okay, it's done. Now I'll just give a line here. I'll stop that ortho. I'm just giving a randomly a line here, skip, then again enter. And I'll just give a line here. I'm just considering that. Okay, it's done. Now just see here, our shape are coming. Okay, or that this is the foundation shape, and here are column cross shape. That wall are coming, and I hope so. It will come quickly. Now, and thanks that you are staying with us till now. So here, it's done. Now I'll just fillet here, then click F, then enter, then here one are given, so if you new, then click radius, then select the first point and second point, it's done. Again enter, then the object first and second, it's done. And here also you can give enter that point and that point. Just see here, it's giving a good shape. And so select enter, that select that point and that point. Actually I have shown you everything about that topic in AutoCAD. Okay, so if you new here, you can watch that. So now just see here, and just see here, our foundation is ready, our foundation is perfectly ready. Now we have to draw our stirrup or our tie bar for here. So here it's very easy, just simply suppose from that point to that point, I'll just consider our tie, okay, here. Now I'll give a spacing of tie, it's 6 inches, and if you have different spacing, then you can give. So to reduce time, I'm just giving that, though it's 6 inches, okay, then give it 6, then enter. So just simply click here, then click here till top. Okay, we'll go till top. I just see here, we're perfectly doing that text. It's taking time. I'm sorry for that. Sorry, double enter. Escape, just select and delete that, and here. Oh, here I'll just draw a line here. I'll open with ortho. I'll just draw a line here, and then escape, and also I'll draw a line here with respect to that point here. And here I'll just give the continue sign. Okay, it's done. Now here also we'll give a continuous sign. Actually everything depends on your technique that how you want to complete your work. Actually this totally depend on you. Then enter. Then for that point, that's it. So we have done that perfectly. For all story, okay, it's done. So just see here we have created a section, I mean reinforcement detailing section, with that here everything is okay. Okay, right, everything is okay. Now when it's done, now we have to increase that section actually, because we know that the section with earth or soil, its clear cover should be 3, but here our clear cover is 1.5 only. So I'll just simply take that point like that. So from that point to here I'll take ortho, then 1.5 in that side. Okay, then enter. So from here I'll just go here, cross, and from here again select that, and from that point go 1.5, enter, then go top, and with respect to that point draw your that point and meet it here, then draw. Now trim tier, double enter, then trim it. Just see here, or that section is ready. Actually we have to first delete that, delete, then we have to use trim, double enter, then trim it, then again trim it, and from here it's done actually. Okay, so just see here, it's done, our that section are ready. Okay, our section are ready. Now in our next video I'll just give that dimension, and also I'll draw our schedule. Okay, I'll just draw our schedule. So I think if you think that that's helpful for you, then please don't forget to subscribe to our channel and also stay with us. And in our next video I'll just show you about schedule. So if you hear, that means you're really interested about that topic, so I think that will be also helpful for you. So stay with us and stay connected with us. Like our video, share our video, and don't forget to leave a comment. Your own like and on share inspires for the next ride. So thank you very much.